The 2021-2022 Premier League season kicks off tonight with Brentford versus Arsenal. So, this is my Premier League predictions for the upcoming season. I will obviously go from 20th up all the way to the champions that I think will win it. So, very simple. Starting off in 20th, I think it's got to be Crystal Palace. I think looking at how they've signed this summer, I don't really think they've strengthened the squad compared to last season. I think this Palace got a bit worse. They've lost Van Aanholt, Klein, Townsend. Then kind of a couple of key players, they've lost Wayne Hennessy, which I don't think he's not really a starter, but that player around the club kind of helps. You're kind of looking at leaders like Sacco that they've also released. They have signed, I think it's an under-23 player from Chelsea for about 20 million, which I don't think is great. They said, I think, Joachim Andersen for Lyon for about 6 million, which I think is a bit more, but I don't know. Which is a decent signing, but I don't think it's really got to be at that level to kind of keep him up. I think he was a film last season, or season prior. But honestly, I don't think it's going to be a great season for Palace. Even the likes of Wilfred Zaha, and that could help him, I don't think it's going to be it. I think it's going to be their time to finally drop back into the Championship. Moving on to 19th place, which you already have seen on screen, is Newcastle United. I think after last season, the only reason they were saved was because Fulham just weren't good enough. I think with the teams that you see now, that have came up, the likes of Brentford, Watford and Norwich, I think they're all good enough to survive and fight to survive and dig Newcastle into the Championship. They have seen no one, they have released Atsu, I think Lejeune's loan has ended, they've released Andy Carroll, they've released Savvy, they're loan for Mutu, whatever you'd say, the Japanese strikers ran out. They need to sign anyone to replace them. It's just not great for them. I think their squad is good, but I think after the last few seasons, we've seen them on a steady decline. I think it's time to see true Geordie's team in the Championship for this season. And moving on to the final team that I think will be relegated for this upcoming season is Brentford. Now, I think that where you've seen Brentford play over the last few seasons in the Championship, they've been playing very good football. They have signed Celtic's Christopher Ayer, I think Onyenka, I think you pronounce his name, from Midtjylland. They signed a Chelsea youth player, which won't play at all. They've only had really, not merely significant players leave, especially being like backup players, just their loans expire, which ain't bad, you're not losing any key players. Will Ivan Toney be able to step up to the Premier League? I think he will. I don't really know how many goals he'll score this season, if he'll help Brentford survive. I think it's between Brentford and then the team I've put 17th that will fight out all season for that last relegation spot. I think Brentford have enough to stay up, but they'll need to be get off to a great start to actually have a chance. If they can get off to a good start, I think they can survive. It's just about can they kick off well and maintain that. Moving into 17th place, so I think we'll just avoid relegation and dig Brentford into it, is Burnley. Now, Burnley have signed Nathan Collins. I think it is Wayne Hennessy on a free. I can't remember who else. They've sold Ben Gibson, which I don't know if he was playing much last season. They released Robbie Brady. Not much about Burnley. They've usually had a good start. They kind of have enough in them, enough of a dog in it to actually survive, which is obviously credit to Burnley themselves, which I think that's where they'll finish 17th and just survive in the Premier League this season. Now, moving on to 16th place, which I think will be Norwich City. Norwich, after winning the Championship last season, have went on a good spending spree. They have signed, I think it's Rashica from Werder Bremen, Ben Gibson from Burnley, I think it's Demetrios Giulianis, a Greece left-back, I think from Olympiacos or something it is, Melo from Nice, Agnes Gunn from Southampton, and picking up young Billy Gilmore from Chelsea on a season-long loan. In the process of selling Buendia to Aston Villa, kind of subsidising that money and releasing Varnich and not really many other key players of life the club Bob Wendia from last season's title win. Now, you've got a couple of good players returning from loan, like Kenny McLean and that. You've got Todd Cantwell, Max Aaron still at the club, Timo Pukki. Can these players keep Norwich up this time round? I think they will. Last time they got relegated, I think dead last. I think Daniel Farke has definitely picked up on mistakes from last time. You can't just go into a penalty season and not sign anyone from the Championship. You've got to sign players like, don't sign like 15, 20 players. Sign like 5 to 8 players that are playing at a good level in their respective countries. Like Rashika, yes, he got relegated. Melu, I think they were like mid-table Lagoon and that, but I think they're good players to kind of help Norwich survive this season. Moving on to 15th place, I think it's going to be Brighton. They've signed a midfielder, Mwepu, definitely butchered it, but also is what it is. They've signed, I think it's Ajax backup Sherpin, goalkeeper, which they've not really strengthened. They've actually lost, I think, more than they've strengthened. They've released Matthew Ryan, Esquerdo, Bernardo, Proper, Soja Hambash, sold Ben White for 50 million. If they can sign a few players, I think they can survive. I do think they will, but it will be a big struggle this season compared to last. Moving on to 14th place, I think it's going to be Watford. They have signed a few players that are decent. Dennis from Club Bruges, Danny Rose from Tottenham on a fee, Josh King on a fee, Petr Etebo for Stoke, Ashley Fletcher from Middlesbrough, I think it is. I think it's Imran Lazaro, I don't know how you pronounce his name, for 9 million. They've also released, well, not released, but I think they've sold Craig Dawson back to West Ham and also Ben Wilmot, which is fairly good. I think that's got enough of it in it to survive this season. I think the likes of Israel Saw, Troy Deeney, Tom Cleverley, the defence has got to be solid enough. I think they will survive quite comfortably. 13th, you've got Southampton. You've not really got... You've got Southampton, which they've just sold Danny Ings, and I think 2 days ago, well, last week I think it was actually, it was a surprising one, him moving on. They've not really strengthened, but they've not really lost. They've sold a backup couple of players. Ryan Bertrand's been released. I think it's one of those who is good, but I don't think they'll push on to push for a top half finish. I think a 13th place is more than respectable to Southampton. Moving on to 12th place, I think it's going to be Wolverhampton Wanderers. Now, they have lost their manager, Nuno Espirito Santos, I think you pronounce it. Or you say it exactly. He has now joined Tottenham Hotspurs. He left the club initially before they died a few weeks away before joining Tottenham. They've lost Rui Patricio, the starting goalkeeper, replaced him with, I think, Olympiacos' Jorge Sá. They've not really strengthened, apart from maybe Trincao from Barca, but they've not really lost players. So, if the new manager, I don't know his name, I think it's another Portuguese person, if he can play attractive football, I think they will have a good season with, well, Jimenez hopefully going to be back for the start after his skull injury. You've got more players, you've got Trincao now. You've got Neto, you've got Podence, you've got a good balanced midfield, good balanced defence. I think it's going to be a good season for Wolves. But I don't think it's going to be a pushing for Europe this season. I think it's just going to be 12th. Moving on to 11th, I think it's going to be Leeds United. I think the way we watched them play last season, Bielsa played them great football. They have strengthened, I'd say. Junior Firpo and Jack Harrison has been signed permanently. They've not really lost any key players. I think with a season under their belt in the Premier League, one more season, I think, this season, then they'll probably push for a top of finish next season. Moving on to Everton now. They have lost Ancelotti to Real Madrid, replacing him with Rafa Benitez. Now, they have signed Demarai Gray for about 2 million. Townsend and Begovic on a free. They sold Bernard for about 1 million. Josh King, they lost on a free. Theo Walcott, they lost on a free. Not really strengthened, not really lost. I don't see them finishing any higher than 10th. Moving on to ninth place, I think it's going to be West Ham United. Now, West Ham have released, I think it's, who is it, Fabian Balbuena. They have signed Craig Dawson on a permanent, Alphonso Areola on a season-long loan with option to buy, which is good. They've not really lost any pure key players, so I think they will finish 6th as they did last season, playing 9th, just missing out. As you see, 8th place, I've got Arsenal. They've signed Nuno Tavares for 7 million. Albert Simbia Okonga, I think you pronounce it, for about 16 million. Ben White for 50. Guendouzi and Saliba has went out on loan. David Luiz is still yet to find a club after being released. 8th place, same as last season, or they can play first worse if they don't really step it up. 7th place, I think it's going to be Tottenham Hotspurs. Signed Brian Gill for 22.5 million, plus Eric Lamela. Golini, I think, is from Atlanta on a season-long loan with the option to buy. They've sold Juan Foyt, Alderweireld, Joe Hart, Danny Rose. Lamela's also went out, Gazzaniga's went out. Really key players, but I think they'll have enough. If they keep Harry Kane, they'll finish 7th. If they don't, I think 10th. They'll shit the bed that much. Moving on to 6th place is Aston Villa for me. Yes, they have recently just lost Jack Grealish. They have signed Buendia for 35 million, Danny Ings for 30, Leon Bailey for 30, Ashley Young for on a fee from Inter. They have sold Samata, Tom Heaton, Engels, Neil Taylor, El Mohamedy, and Jack Grealish for 100 million. It's going to be very big for them this season. If they kept Jack Grealish, I think they would have pushed for a top four this season. But I think with the players that they've signed to replace him, it's definitely going to be enough to see them kind of push up for, I would say then, a top six finish, to see how they'll kind of gauge it, to see how they'll kind of go, and they'll push to hopefully finish in Europe for the first time in fuck knows how long. Moving on to 5th place, I've got Leicester City. I think they'll finish 5th if I think the 3rd season in a row. They'll just miss out on Champions League football yet again. I think they've signed Bazen Daka for 27 million. Bakary Soumaré from Lille for about 18 to 20 million. Ryan Bezard on a free, which has strengthened the squad good in key areas. A backup striker for Foden and Iheanacho. Backup holder and fielder. Backup left back. They've also got rid of long time serving Christian Fuchs. Wes Morgan's retired. I think Matty James has left also. Not really players that are like heavy, key, playing 35 plus games. I think 5th place season is going to be a good place for them. I can't see them pushing all the way, as they've done the last two seasons, for a Champions League place, but I think they will drop out, as they have done. Now 4th place for Chelsea, as simple as they've not really signed anyone, I think, apart from a backup film goalkeeper in Bettinelli. They've sold Tomori, Victor Moses and Olivier Giroud. I think with Thomas Tuchel, it's going to be a better tactical season. You probably will see a better kind of riding the wave compared to last season under Frank Lampard. But I don't think it's going to be enough to kind of go for a top 3 or even top 2. 3rd place, I've gone with Liverpool, as you can tell. They've only signed Ibrahima Konate for 36 million, sold Harry Wilson, or your, I don't know how you pronounce it, but for about 6 million. They've released Gini Wijnaldum as he won his contract to join PSG. I think if they when they have Virgil van Dijk this season back, Joe Gomez back, you'll see them kind of being back to a better position. You'll really see if their attack will actually recover this season, which I think they will, but I don't think they'll finish anywhere in the top 2. Now as you can tell, I've put Manchester United in 2nd place. At the current time of recording, they have signed Jadon Sancho and Rafael Varane. Picked up Tom Heaton on a fee, without really selling anyone. Put out a couple of youth players on loan. And that, they've not put out any significant players. So I think as second place season, if they can sign a Wilfred Ndidi, like I've done in the video, I would say sign Sancho, Varane, they need a Ndidi or another holding midfielder. back up right back, they'll push for the title. There's reports of they will make a third significant signing, whether that's a midfielder or a right back, we'll need to wait and see. But I think they will finish second this season. Now, as you can tell, champions are Manchester City for me personally. They have signed Jack Grealish for $100 million, signed Scott Carson on a fee, while selling Angelino, Jack Harrison, M. Cheka, I think you'd say, Aguero and Eric Garcia on a free transfer. I think this season you'll see City step up even more. Clubs now have got an actual proper pre-season instead of like 2 to 3 weeks where the players are trying to recover and then come back into it. But I think City are going to be 2 months this season. Maybe if United sign like a Wilfred Ndidi for that holding midfield position, they'll push him, but I think it'll be a closer this season for the title, but I think City will just run away with it. But with that, that is the end of the video. If you've liked it, subscribe, leave a like on the video, subscribe to the channel, turn on post notifications. But with that, hope you've enjoyed Brentford Force also tonight. If you watched this video before the kickoff, which will be out probably about 3 or 4 hours before, then ultimately leave your score predictions below. Don't cheat. And with that, I'll catch you in the next one, and goodbye.